Welcome to Up Up Down Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed. We got T Breezy.
Summer Slam time.
GM mode.
Show 20, bud.
He was very rude to me. He was very rude to me.
Excuse me.
Played a lot of cards on me. Took out three of my matches on a card where I need a lot of matches. All right, so let's just get to work.
Let's get to work, bud. No time limit. You know the deal.
Great.
Get up in there for the old PPV. SummerSlam, show 20 of 25. We're almost halfway through our season.
Also, too, so this is messed up because Bailey expects to make an appearance. So is that going to make her mad
now? She's going to be very mad.
Well, she shouldn't be because, like, you did that to me.
Wait, hold on. Go back to the deal. Drew expects the main event this week.
Yeah.
He expects the main event of the pay-per-view.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Okay.
What?
That's a big demand.
That's fine. No problem with that.
Okay.
This is the issue.
What's the issue?
We got another deal here, but that's $200,000.
Yowza.
$37,000.
Yowza.
Money.
Ooh, money. Yikes.
Money is important.
Yikes.
Okay. What do we even? Okay.
You were feeling great going into this pay-per-view, by the way.
I was. And I still have stuff.
You still have stuff.
I still have a lot of stuff.
You still have more than enough.
You know, because I can't put Bailey on the show. I can put Ray and Dre. Are you guys off cooldown yet? Can you guys be off cooldown, please? Goodness! Get off this cooldown.
Drive around cooldown, dude.
They were killing it, and then they haven't been on the show, so they've just been hurt.
Yeah.
You
got lots of peeps.
I do.
Massive roster.
Okay. These are all angles, but I would love a tag match. You know what I can do, though? I can.
There's some rivalries going.
I have rivalries. These are all rivalries. I have a bunch of rivalries cooking right now. This is the title we can put on the line. My women's title is off the show right now. My men's title is off the show, right? Yeah, no, because that's Nash and Bunny. Dope, okay. Boom. Women's title's off because of Bailey. Tag titles are off, or not. Women's title's off because of Shayna. Women's tag titles are off because Gigi and Bailey. Men's tag titles. We have tag champs?
I feel like I haven't seen you with tag champs. They might be vacant, dude.
They might be.
You must have lost somebody and it vacated them.
Let me see something. Let's see something.
Yep.
I suck at this game.
Wow. It must have been on someone who snuck out of there.
They've been running these tag matches with no titles in play. What the hell's wrong with me? That's 10 extra points of popularity. Mm-hmm. Oh, man. And I guarantee that everyone has been yelling at me for the past, like, 8 weeks.
Yes, yes. My favorite is everybody notices everything, and
we do not.
Yeah, it's different. It's different when the heat's on here.
It is. So you know what? I can do that, and it won't kill... No, what are you doing?
No, it doesn't kill it. A rivalry.
It won't kill their other rivalry. Right?
No. No, it just won't start a rivalry.
I'll throw him there. Then Kombucha is going to get hurt. I have no doubt in my mind Kombucha will get hurt.
Might. Kombucha. Kombuch.
You know what we can do?
What can we do?
Maybe I put Booker and Steiner on a team and win the titles, and then the next week they'll have matches and they'll each have a tag title on the opposite teams. Oh, I hate this, dude.
I told you, dude, the pay-per-views are chaos. We know this.
Okay, I know this is going to bang. I know that's going to bang. I'm not sure about that. That'll be good. This would be a title match. Okay, I need a tag match for the show to round itself out. What is this pose that Six is doing?
I don't know.
He's carrying two watermelons.
A little bit. Flexed. So flexed.
Tag.
What are you thinking here, bud? Walk us through it.
I'm thinking I go Kane and Leviathan against Finn and Six.
It's not bad.
For the tag titles. And that way, we got extra popularity on Kane or extra popularity on Six and their angle. But then I've got to get these two, Leviathan and Finn, into something with that's not with each other.
Because they're cool down.
Yeah. And everybody's stamina is pretty solid, so I can just put them in whatever match I want, and it'll save some of the show.
No.
So we'll go tag match there, and then we'll just rectify who's champions at a later date. I'll fix something.
Sure.
I can do a three-way tag, can I?
No.
No? Okay. But then we can do a tag with a interference. Yeah. So whoever ends up being champions, I'll just fix a match or run in on it so that...
Screw them over, take the titles off.
Somebody else has the titles in effect. Okay. Cool. Tag title match right there. Okay. New women's champion, just come out and talk to the people. Hey, good to see y'all.
Let me talk to you. She could also call out Shayna and keep their rivalry going.
Can she call out Shayna even though she can't be on the show?
Yeah.
No, she can't.
Yeah.
Yes, she can.
Because they're the second person is always the, like, doesn't really matter what they're doing. They're just like a nothing.
You know what we'll do here?
Friendly on pay-per-view day.
Yeah.
Everybody likes pay-per-view
day. I appreciate that. I just need to see, okay, so you're upset, Book. So what if you call out Rick? Does that make you happy?
They got a rivalry.
Yeah, but
why is Book so hot?
Huh?
Why is Book so hot?
I don't know, he's angry about something.
He's so mad.
I think they've been losing to them a lot.
Ah, okay.
Okay. Call out Flame. Or keep some stuff going. Who else can we get cooking? Let's go advertise. Go Cindy Fluff with the 5 popularity. She's so upset. Let's go Flint.
Mick Stones, dude. Money,
please. Or advertise. I need you to keep your popularity. I need you to keep yours too.
Cindy Flizoff.
No, because she's not gonna make me any money.
True. 5 popularity.
Not gonna make me anything.
What have you done to her?
I could run Asuka into the ground.
You already have, basically.
Well, she's gotta heal up anyway.
She's healed fully.
You know what? Boom. Advertise. Money, yeah. Okay.
Money. Yeah.
Negative. Okay. Jeez. So then the age-old question, is this going to be better? But I don't have money for that regardless, so.
We don't know.
We're here. Okay, power cards.
It's always the age-old question. We never know.
Age-old question. Interference book the show, add 2, no. 3 special effects. How much are my special effects? 10K? No, we're not going to use that yet. 3 booking crew. How much is my booking crew? 10K? No. Okay. How was my average?
15K.
No, we're not there yet. Okay.
I knew it was coming.
Okay, injury rehab. Nope. Extreme rules, cage match, and an Iron Man match. Okay. I can throw this in a cage. Can't, do I have the money? Okay, cage match for the title. You guys are in a great spot. Extreme rules. Okay. Extreme rules for the title. I have $20,000 left.
My God, you're going all out here, bud. I'm going, dude. I can't believe you're doing this.
You know what? I might need to save that 10K.
Oh.
Let me get those free special effects.
You might need to.
I need that money back.
This show is getting expensive.
Yeah, but I want that health spot too, though. What else was it? It was cage match, extreme rules, and an Iron Man. Iron Man is cheap, right?
I think so.
If I throw you guys in an Iron Man tag match, that doesn't work. Okay, we can't do that. What if you guys are in an Extreme Rules match? And then this is the Iron Man match. Do we have the money? We have the money.
Interesting.
Stamina cost is very high, though. Okay. Title on the line. So, Iron Man match. Oh, because they didn't set the Extreme Rules. Extreme Rules match. Steel cage match. Yes. Okay, now cards. Okay, real steel. One cage match. Boom. One cage match ordered.
One cage. Pizza.
One Iron Man match. Iron Man match coming
Iron
up.
Iron Man.
And an Extreme Rules match.
Extreme.
It's coming up. Do your dance.
It's coming up.
Oops. Okay. So, Iron Man match. Card played. Title on the line. Ray Dre, champion. Here we go. Normal. No, it's not going to be it might be because I don't have the money.
Yikes.
Level 3 rivalry, Drew and Giovanni. They gave me 3-5 last time. That's fine. What is it, though? Can we do something, guys? Tables. I have $1,000.
You're a lunatic.
Extreme rules.
I can't believe you're doing this.
We need the titles on the line.
Oh my God!
This is I'm banking everything on SummerSlam, dude.
You're happy, yeah. You're going all out here, bud.
Becky Lynch and Gigi. Stamina 51. They're gonna get the tables match instead of these guys. Tables. One on one. Normal. Boom. Okay, so Iron Man title.
Yeah.
Card. Normal. Extreme rules, tag, no rivalry, yeah. Card. Tables match, level 3 rivalry, no card. Main event, cage match, card, heavyweight title. Calling out women's champion, calling out her heel counterpart, boom. Booker T, who's angry, calling out Rick Steiner, just in case we need to pop their solo rivalry in these tag matches. Their popularity is going well. Asuka, she's been hurt on the shelf for a little bit. She's gonna run, get some money for daddy. Flint McStones also getting some money for daddy. And I think we're good. Logistics, all good. Bam, all the bonuses, cool. Manage the roster, I don't have the money to do that. I would buy some cards, but I can't. Injury rehab, free advertising. You know what? No, I'm going to save that just in case. Booking. Yeah, here we go. Okay. All right, we're good.
1,000 left in the bank.
Show. Look at that. I am on the edge.
Okay.
Becky, I need you to be in another movie very soon.
I'm so damn nervous right here. Please. I'm waiting for the... Oh, God. Who are you taking out?
Boom. I told you I was nice.
Cabrera, I'll give you 6 to stay. I don't think so. Thanks for your work.
Come on. Wow. Wow, you're putting people out in the cold.
I will not be renewing clubs. Priestky.
Contract is up. What's he want? 40K. Involved in anything?
I will not be renewing.
Wow.
And then Priest go.
Okay, he said I understand. It's amicable.
Yeah.
Interesting thing happened. Ooh. Everybody's sarcastic.
He's mad that I got involved. Uh-oh. Shelton is not happy. As a former champ, of course he wants a shot at his friggin' title again. Hey, sounds good, bud. Sorry, Shelton. It ain't happening, bud. No?
No. I put the championship on the map. You're going to deny me my rematch? What a joke.
You're still the champ, dude. Relax, man. Too much. All right. Let's have a look here.
Wow.
Oh, my goodness. What a conundrum here.
What's that?
Special promotion is available.
Wow. Also, were we looking at each other's cards before? I feel like we weren't.
We were.
Okay. Because I feel like it's now we just know.
Special promotion is available.
Yeah.
So in almost 20 weeks, this has never popped up as available to buy for me.
Hmm.
But it's also at a very opportune time because we need the big arena, dude. I have to go big arena. I have to. Okay. All right, I'm doing the same as you here, buddy.
You immediately put yourself in the hole.
But.
You can still go get that special promotion.
I have an idea.
You have your whole roster available to you.
You're only gonna be $5,000?
Yeah, it's like GameStop.
That's garbage, dude. You're
trying to get that trade in. But you well use this. This is nowhere in the condition it was when you purchased it, so.
How? They're giving me like $0 for these. I do not want Adrian Buck, but $5,000, that's all I can get? This is garbage.
Well, you've beaten the hell out of these people. Why would they give you more money?
You know what?
Probably get the special promotion.
Let's see what we got. Let's take a look here.
If I were you, I would get it.
I need that special promotion.
You do.
There's got to be a way to get it. And there might be, as I just saw. Free arena booking. Right now, my arena is costing me 75, which is just what I need.
And that's the trade for the card.
That's the trade. Yep. My God.
Nice.
That's what we needed right there. That's still good. Oh my God.
Because it cost you 200K to open it.
Yeah, I knew that.
Just 75 to use it. You gotta pay to play, baby.
75? My God! I don't know if I can get it.
You can.
What do you mean I can't? I won't be able to put on a show. I've booked nothing so far.
You can book... Oh yeah. You haven't done anything.
Literally nothing. Okay. Let's take a look here.
Yeah.
Let's take a look what we got.
Put some stuff on paper. Ooh, stamina.
Stamina is down. Okay, that's good. Tag.
That's... So they're in the level 4 rivalry. Putting that heavyweight title on the line, you're trying to strip Shelton of all his gold.
Relax. Okay. All right, here. Looking okay here. Got four title matches.
I feel like I have 9 more rivalries than you do, but I still came out on the bad end of the stick.
You have another rivalries. You have another rivalries. 2, 3. Let's just see who else we're playing with here. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we've got some other stuff here.
Mm-hmm.
But they haven't really started yet, so. Okay with this. Okay with this. Okay. So let's see what we got for cards. I got a submission match. This is always the tough part for me. Which also, yeah. By the way, since you've already booked it, I was going to let you know, because I don't know if you forgot, but did you forget that you promised Drew the main event?
Yep.
Okay. As soon as you put the titles on the line, I saw you switch them, and I went, you might have forgot.
Yep, I did.
Might have forgot.
Well, all right. Bye-bye, Drew. In like 3 weeks.
Our stamina is starting to hit. Okay.
This is all very painful.
Damn.
It's the stress.
Yeah, you're telling me.
It's the
stress. I want that special promotion card.
Then get it.
I can't.
Are you a man or are you just a little boy?
How dare you?
Huh? What is it?
You have $1,000 currently.
Yeah, so?
You have $1,000 freaking, bud.
Yeah. Also, I'm not looking at any of the season stuff. It's probably another. That's why I just need to sit and play this.
We're not playing doing it. We are not doing
playing
that.
Playing it in 5-minute spurts.
Piper, I was trying to get it going with Grayson. I need some rivalries going here. King called up Eddie. Yeah, that was it. So then we're going to go advertising for Priest because I also just let him go. So Clubberella and Priest, I'm letting go. So they can just kind of do their deal.
Do you think... For the 25th week for Mania, we don't watch each other book the pay-per-views?
I'm okay with it. So it's a surprise?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm cool with that. Okay, so we got level 4. We got level 2. Level 2. Level 3. Level 2. Okay, so these ones are 80 and 60. These ones are all right. These ones are okay. So that's a tough one. That's a tough one.
Damn.
77. 80. Oh, man. But that title's online for that one. This is always a tough one.
No gimmicks yet.
I'm thinking opener and closer. That's a good popularity right there.
I wish when they asked you if they could have main event matches, they would let you like look at the roster before you answered. Like, let me look through my portfolio. But
no, that's how it goes.
No.
Yes. No. Yes.
I want to be able to assess my internal game notes, you know? Uh-oh, dew drops. Got the tables, match glow.
Got that specialty. I've always got that low stam.
Somebody walking out injured.
Nobody's getting injured.
I don't know.
Specialty, okay. A little specialty. You know what? I really want that special promotion.
Then just get it.
I want it, man. That friggin' thing cost me last time. That cost me the entire friggin' season. I don't know if they leveled it out, but it cost me the entire season.
It did not cost you.
Yes, it did.
What costed you is the way that you played your cards.
I didn't fully understand. That's what cost they were.
Huh?
So I didn't fully understand. I had like three of them and I played them back to back to back. I thought
that was dumb.
Because I thought they were special. Like, I thought they were like free special effects or free. I thought it was free promotion. Okay. If I buy it, I have 65,000 left.
Okay. And you can work with that for this show.
Because right now the show costs 46. What a conundrum, dude.
Come on down to the depths.
I have to do it. I have to do it.
Come on down to the depths with your boy.
That's it. I also want this double cost.
Go get the double cost, too.
I can't.
Why not?
Can't do it.
Double cost is really only going to be effective for the next few weeks. See, you got two special promotions anyway, see? So you're good.
So I just got one.
Yeah, I know.
Is there anyone here that can give me any sort of money? Adrian Buck, dude, what are you doing? But you're only 5,000. You're so useless.
You hired him.
And now you're probably no, I don't think so. I think he was gifted to me.
Gifted?
Yeah.
What do you mean gifted?
He was gifted. Like, I'm pretty sure I didn't have enough people to fill out a card, and so Hunter said, here, use this guy.
He's your kombucha?
Yeah. Yeah, kind of.
You don't believe in him. Like, I believe in kombucha.
That's true. Okay, I got the big arena. That's going to make a difference. The big stadium is going to make a difference. We've got all the bonuses here, so we're good.
Big arena is going to make a really big difference money-wise.
I freaking hope. That's what I was aiming. I looked ahead and I saw when it was coming out, and I figured you probably did too. And I figured if I could just...
I'm so focused on trying to keep stamina above water.
Yeah.
That I was like, you know what? I'm just going to not run the big crazy gimmick matches, and then we'll hopefully have enough money by the time we get there. And it's like, no, we still don't.
No, I'm just going to keep it.
Ooh.
I might as well. I got that card. I got to use it, you know?
Full time. Look at that.
Oh, that's double the cost. I didn't know that. If I use free advertising, then I get 10 more thousand, and then I can buy the double cost.
Yep.
I don't want to do it. I can't. Well, how do I?
Come on down.
Oh, God.
Come on down.
Okay, hold on. I got to move this card. All right, advertising for Priest, he's out of here. Advertising for Club Rel, she's out of here. Call out, getting some of these going. That's a level 4 for the title. Both are probably going to get injured. It's just, it is what it is. Okay. That'll be a good match, no matter what. Level 4, high popularity. That's banging. That's no matter what. That's my main event. This one, level 3, good popularity. It's going to do fantastic, I think.
Mm-hmm.
This one right here, level 2, titles on the line. Medium popularity, not too bad. Level 2, it's got higher and lower popularity. Damn.
Mm.
That's a tough one. That's a, like, 88, but then also a 57.
Yeah.
76, 76, but also 50. Oof. That's got to be the weakest. Tables match, level 2. That's got to be it. And the specialty. Not the best popularity, though. Oh my god. If I'd made this a normal match, I could buy the double cost.
Hey.
I can't do it.
Do you believe in your talent or not?
I believe in them.
Here we go.
No, not all. Sorry. But I also need a GM interference. Yeah, let's do it for a title change. So we got tables, level 2, specialty for the women's championship. Men's tag titles, level 2. Women's tag titles for the GM interference. Level 3, Allies of Truth. Level 4 for the title, advertising on two people who are leaving anyway. Two call-outs. I'm not getting this, but it's for a pre-match physio, so I'm not too concerned. Nothing else that I really need to worry about. I've got all the bonuses and the big stadium. Power so cards.
So it begins.
Submission. This is looking okay. Health spa for... I don't really need to. Nah, I don't need to. Okay.
All right.
I feel good about this card.
It's a good card.
And I have barely... you have 1,000. I have 33,000. That's just stupid. Big stadium.
32,000 more than me. And you got the big arena, which you might not be able to use for a few weeks after this show.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. I need some money right here.
But this... You being in the big arena is going to get you a ton of money.
I hope. This is, again, it's always that conundrum of there's a bonus for SummerSlam.
Yeah.
If you use the SummerSlam arena. But show quality goes up. Oh my God, look at the capacity. 12.5 to 42.5. So there's 30,000 more people.
Ticket price is an extra dollar.
Yikes.
So you're gonna, here. Hold on, let me just see.
Oh my goodness.
What is it, 12.5?
So 12.5 at $7. So if I sold out, how much money would I make?
87,000 if you're sold out.
Okay.
Now if I'm sold out, because I'm at that arena.
Okay.
87,000 if I sell out.
Now the big stadium, 42.5 times 8.
340,000.
Good God, man. Yeah, I made the right call.
Yeah.
And the show quality goes up.
2%, yeah.
Okay.
So it's legit, just like you have the opportunity to gain... To make $250,000 more on this show from ticket sales than I do.
I'm okay with it.
Whew! Yikes. Yikes. Whew! Here we go. We got SummerSlam. I'm about to crush. I got a hell of a show. I'll be honest, at this point, I don't even remember what I booked.
Surprise, surprise.
Well, it's been like 3 weeks for us.
I like how you had no idea. You just went, oh, I'm going to kill it. Yep, whatever. Oh,
well, I... I have faith in past me.
I have faith in that big arena. Let's,
okay. So, oh yeah. Oh, you're going to make so much more money than me. All right.
Forget.
Yeah. Do drop an EO spectate. Dang it.
We got, I guess,
dang it.
Like in the middle of the app, so we don't need to
open it. No. No. We're all good. We're throwing it right back in.
There we go. All right. SummerSlam time.
Can you hear?
I can hear. No.
Okay.
I turned it down because I got you.
Okay, yeah, I can't either. Also, I'm... Ugh, the arena looks so good. Dang it.
That's a big arena.
I'm screwed. I'm not going to be able to get big arena for like 6 weeks. I don't have the money.
Really?
Unless I get another movie deal.
Yeah, well, you never know. I mean, they've been... I feel like Triple H has been throwing you some bones here.
Just one or two.
Three, like three at least.
No.
Yeah.
You have two of those cards.
Of what cards?
The good cards that keep your fans intact.
You have, first off, you have several good cards.
Yeah, but that's the best card.
Well, I'm pretty sure you have one too.
I have, maybe.
Yeah, and you got cheat code, which you still haven't used.
Well,
what? Yeah, that's well. Right. Triple H, he gave you a movie deal. He pulled you out of the gutter. You were broke.
No, he didn't give it to me. Becky Lynch earned it.
At one point, you had $1,000 left. And then all of a sudden, a miraculous movie deal pops up and gives you a couple hundred G's. Come on.
Why? No, it was like 35K.
Definitely more than that. Definitely more than that.
I also think that I'm sitting at like $200, something like that right now.
I think both of us are very low right now.
Yeah.
I think we put everything we had into SummerSlam.
Yeah. And you're look at the depth of field. Look at all those people in the background, the horizon.
I got that big arena, dude.
There's so many people there, they're blurred out.
You couldn't afford the big arena, huh?
No, I couldn't. Damn. Not even close. Damn. You're gonna make so much money on this show, it's gonna be stupid. How come you're always in the money lead?
Because I keep an eye on it. You go all out, and then all of a sudden you have like $1,000 and you wonder why. Whereas I've been keeping an eye on my money. And remember, there was a time you had like 100,000 and I had 1,000,000. And then you caught up. We were both like at about 1 mil, and then we both went broke. And then now I think currently we're both broke.
But you just... But I win in the end, so that's okay.
You win one time.
Which was... Which time?
Yeah,
you're only as good as your last match. Ouch.
Relax.
Ouch, bud.
I like how we have SummerSlam, by the way, and SummerSlam just happened. We're almost in line.
Yeah. Well, this is... We still got, a few weeks before this airs?
Maybe only one or two. I feel like I feel like we're, like, caught up.
We need to fill. We need to fill.
I feel like we're caught up.
We might need to record some more after this.
We got lucky because the Summer Games popped up there, but... I feel like Extreme Rules aired and maybe one other one, so we're probably like two weeks maybe.
Okay, we gotta.
But
I got so much left to do.
We gotta pick it up, son.
But then next week I gotta go and host a conference, and then I come home for a day, and then I'm leaving to go to Rough and Rowdy.
Oh my god! Oh, that's awesome.
I'm so excited.
No, dude, I see all the stuff they post, and it's just, it looks great.
Have you ever watched one?
I've watched a few. I've never seen them in person, though. I feel like in person would be great. You should go. That's like your Brawl for All. You love Brawl for All.
I don't want to be in Brawl for All. I want to just commentate on it.
I feel like you do okay.
I would do great, but I'm not going to do it.
You know who did a Rough and Rowdy?
It's Hornswoggle.
Did he?
Yes, and Heath.
And Heath. That was the one I was going to say. Heath did a Rough and Rowdy.
He was a Golden Gloves boxer.
He was very good, and I think he won the Rough and Rowdy. He won.
I don't doubt it.
He said, ooh, if you have any sort of endurance at all, he goes, you can win.
Yeah. Well, I think Heath was in an early one, like the sixth one or something. But
probably.
This one that I'm going to next week is 22.
Yep.
I didn't know about it until Swoggle was on it. And so I saw that. I saw, Swoggle's boxing? Oh,
yeah.
I bought the pay-per-view instantly.
You never even heard of Rough and
Rowdy? No, I'd never heard of it.
My God.
It just wasn't in my algorithm, I guess.
It's always kind of been around, but like they started beefing it up with like these promos. So
they
started being characters and stuff. And man,
bro,
there's some good ones. There's some good ones. Check out their Instagram.
It's yeah.
Good stuff.
To get ready, so we went back and we found a way to watch some of the other ones, the old ones.
Yep.
And so we've been watching them. And then I'm just watching all the YouTube clips, too.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
There's a guy. So my buddy that's going with me, he trains at a boxing gym. And one of the guys there is in Rough and Rowdy.
Ooh,
okay. I think he's the black Italian stallion.
Okay.
I think that's his thing.
I like that.
But he's gonna be fighting when we're there.
Oh, my God.
I'm so excited.
That's cool. I feel like almost anything live is really good.
Yeah.
Like, just live stuff is so cool.
And I assume that there's people watching this that might not know what Rough and Rowdy is. We should probably tell them. It's a boxing event, and it's sometimes been deemed the biggest knockout party of the year.
Yeah.
It's 3 1-round boxing matches, but as soon as one match ends, they're already like bringing in the next people to fight. It's like, it's very fast, so it might be like 20 or 30 fights in a night.
Well, and I think it's like a tournament style, right? So you might fight two or three times.
And the ones that I've seen, I haven't seen that.
Oh, because maybe that's how they used to do it. You had to kind of advance and then go, you know what I mean?
That's sick if they used to do that.
I'm pretty sure.
The ones that I've seen is just a bunch of one-on-ones, just back to back to back.
I swear Heath told me like he had to fight like two or three times and then he won.
That's freaking awesome. I need to find that and watch it.
Yeah, because by the end, like, if you've already had one or two fights, you're gassed at the end, dude.
Yeah, especially if you got the crap beat out of you.
Yeah, yeah. I think it's tournament style.
I cannot imagine a boxing tournament. Oh,
like
is this
UFC style?
Through the table? Okay. Are you behind?
I might be behind. They're just about to do a Spanish fly.
Oh, you're way behind.
Whoa! Okay.
You're like 10, maybe 15 seconds behind me. Okay, there, let's do this. Did that advance it?
That advanced it.
Okay, good.
We are now caught up. We are still recording. I'm on, you're on. We're good. 4.5, rivalry grows. EO new champ. Moving on.
Ooh. I mean, great for EO, but 4.5 stars, I don't like that.
I like that.
All right, advertising. Boom.
Okay.
18 hundo.
A little bit of money, nothing crazy for Cliff.
Money's... All right, here we go. Modern day Vikings. Spectane.
Was normal tag. For the Tigers.
Yeah. Straight up, let's see. Rivalry?
Rivalry, yes. Level 2 rivalry.
Okay.
So not sure if it'll cap it off here, but...
I don't know, man. I don't know. Don't know if it'll hold up, you know.
Look at that big arena, though, dude.
It's huge.
That is a big arena.
That's like, you can sell like, what, like 50,000 more tickets than I can?
A lot of tickets.
Even if they're like $3 a pop, it's still...
it is packed. They're hanging from the rafters, dude.
Man, come on, dude. Woo. Give me some money. Why do you have a second announce table if they're not going to sit there, you know?
Big arena.
I'm jealous about that.
I can put a couple of announce tables in there if we needed to.
Have you seen Barbie, though?
I have not.
Bro, you got to see Barbie.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's awesome. Hell of a movie.
Wow.
I feel like when I first saw the previews, I was like, oh, this is just going to be like what you think it would be hearing. Oh, there's a Barbie movie. Like, oh, this is just like random Barbie movie. It's funny and whatever. Yep. Very fluff. It is not at all. It
really?
It is a movie.
So it lives up to the hype, huh?
Yeah, man, it's really good.
Interesting.
And the soundtrack is freaking unbelievable.
That I had a feeling that would win you over.
Oh yeah.
You're a big soundtrack guy.
Yeah, got to. That there's a Dua Lipa song on there. Psh,
psh. What's it called?
It's great. I think it's called Dance the Night. Dance the night away. Watch me.
Did they? Did they have Barbie Girl in there?
There's versions of it.
Okay.
There's like a Nicki Minaj remix, I think.
Interesting.
Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting. Okay. I was gonna say that's like an iconic one. You gotta have that on there somewhere.
Yeah, bro. You gotta see this movie. It's really good. Have you been to the movies lately?
Yeah, actually, there's a really nice movie theater near us that we go to every now and then.
Ooh, so okay.
I feel like the last one we saw was Mission Impossible.
What'd you think?
Awesome, love it. I'm a big Mission Impossible
guy. I gotta see it. Have you seen all of them?
Yeah.
I don't think I've seen all of them.
Well, so the funny part is we just marathoned them.
Oh, nice.
I haven't seen any of them.
Yeah.
So we watched all of them back to back to back in line with the new one coming out, and my God.
Yeah.
That's good.
This is the 7th one, right?
6 or 7. I want to say 7. Because I think this is part 1, then they have part 2. So
oh.
7 and 8.
Okay.
And it's good. Dude. Dope. Yeah, it's
so
good.
We got another one coming then.
I also just marathoned Insidious.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I need to marathon those. I've seen them all in the theaters.
Yeah.
But not quickly back to back.
The new Insidious, good.
Yeah.
Good. I thought it wrapped up everything nicely, but not one of the scarier ones. But
yeah, yeah.
They do a very good job of like intertwining all the stories.
Yeah, which there's what, 4 or 5 of those, something like that.
I'm gonna say 5.
I feel like I remember the first one being the first time I was scared in the movie theater in like a long time.
Really?
Yeah, because I love horror movies. So when we lived in Florida,
yep.
I would go to the movies probably once a week. And just see whatever I hadn't seen, because I freaking love the movies. And it's a different time, you know. We had free time. It's crazy. It's like being in college.
I used to do the go to the movies for one movie and then watch 3.
Oh yeah, 2 for Tuesdays.
Y'all, stay in the theater, like just literally stay in the theater or go to the theater. Great.
Yeah. There was one day I was at the movies by myself, and I saw Rowan also at the movies by himself, and we were walking in to see the same movie.
Yep.
We're like, oh, okay, let's go.
There you go.
But yeah, go see horror movies, and it's like, okay, this is like good, but you're not like scared in the theater. Bro, in Insidious, when they're looking for the sound of like the hands clapping, and then they're sitting on those basement stairs and the hands pop up out of the shadows and clap, I was like, okay, this is good. This is really good. Yeah. Whoa! Ooh, they retain after the... Bro, he did the frog splash in Eddie's face.
I know. Relatively
brutal.
Relatively
Well.
I'm okay with that. Give me a 3.5-4 right now.
That's not even long enough to put the YouTube ads on his stuff. Come on, Logan Paul. You gotta hit 8 minutes, dude. I heard that movie Talk to Me is really good. So it came out last week? 2 weeks ago? Something like that? I don't even know what it's about. I don't want to watch the previews. Every time it comes up, I turn it off.
Yeah.
But they're like grabbing a dead hand or something like that. Oh, 4?
Hell
dang.
Yeah, dude.
Dang it.
We'll take that all day.
Kofi and I just came back to Raw.
I saw that.
And we wrestled the Vikings. And Ivar splashed me off the top rope.
Yeah?
That sucked, dude.
How'd that feel?
I'm gonna be perfectly honest with you. That was terrible. I got up the next morning like, what happened to my body? You know, it's like I think I like almost blew my O-ring out.
Wow. Okay.
Ooh, new rivalry.
New rivalry starting up.
For those kids not knowing anatomy, you can blow your O-ring out by putting too much pressure.
GM interference on this one, so you gotta simulate.
Ah. Unfortunately.
Two?
Let's see. Who do we think's gonna get it?
Three and a half.
Oh!
Oh my god! That's better than I could have even hoped for.
Rivalry grows from 2 to 4.
Woo! Woo!
Kane calling out Eddie Guerrero.
And that was, hold on, that was Brox.
Yeah. And Shotzi.
And Shotzi, my goodness.
Great
and
job.
A rivalry growing for Eddie and Kane. My goodness. We'll get this rivalries popping for after SummerSlam.
Bro, see, also too, Eddie loses his tag match.
Yep.
And then Kane calls him out to add insult to injury. This is...
Open that rivalry, dude.
All right. Truth and Elias.
Woo.
Singles, normal. Give me 2 stars. Rivalry on this?
R-Truth and Elias.
Spectate.
Oh, yeah. Level 3.
3? Damn.
Level 3. This is a good PPV. Dude.
Yeah. This is the Nashville graphic too for SummerSlam. And you're in Lafayette. They're going to level Elias. And
that.
Truth. This is a music match.
We got that. Yeah.
This is the music match.
City, USA, dude. And we got that big arena. Don't forget.
I don't know. If Elias comes out singing Rap is Crap.
Oh. Slab nuts. It's great.
Oh, man. Here
that?
We go.
How are you feeling so far with my...
I think your pay-per-view is something that the people can really get behind, really excited. But even though mine is in a smaller arena, it's very much like ECW. Like, you got the big show, you got the glitz, the glam, the marketing, you're making the money. But the real wrestling fans know, like, we're about to get grimy and our pay-per-view is going to bang, you know? And we're going to get rewarded for that in the end.
I think so.
Yeah. So you can have your talks in People Magazine and your champions on Good Morning America, but the real wrestling fans, they know. They know where the wrestling's at. They know. Yeah, they know where the big people play. Oh, big miss. You tried it. You thought.
You got these rivalries cooking.
Suplex.
Can't beat a good rivalry, man.
No. Okay. Elias.
I believe we're, what, week 16? I feel like week 16.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what's crazy? How long was Elias playing the guitar on TV?
Long time.
Was it a long time, or did it feel like a long time?
You trying to say it was like less than a year?
No. Definitely more than a year. Like 2 years?
2 years, maybe.
I need to check.
Where's he been? What's he been doing?
I'm not sure. But it was like one of my favorite things on the show.
It was very hot. Very hot.
Yeah. And the fact that he has a full album.
Yeah.
And it's like really good, and we just like don't talk about it.
Never. Barely acknowledged.
Yeah. I'm like, are we serious? Like, he's like one of the most jacked people I've ever seen in my life, and he's got like a hit album. We're just not gonna speak on this.
And who else got some albums?
Who's that? Hell yeah. And he's got moves.
He's got lots of albums.
Oh. R-Truth or K-Quick?
Ooh, I love K-Quick.
We getting rowdy.
Oh, I might like K-Quick more than
Truth. Wow.
Put Get Rowdy up against What's Up.
Ooh.
That's a, like...
Ooh, I don't know.
I'm putting this out there. But if our peeps have the ability to put the poll right now, I would love to see what the peeps think of either What's Up or Get Rowdy.
We gotta ask R-Truth what he thinks.
Man.
Which one does he like better?
He's got a preference.
Oh, he's got to.
What do you think he likes better?
I feel like he likes Get Rowdy better.
Get Rowdy was more like short-lived, but I feel like he felt it.
Yeah, yeah, me too. Get Rowdy! We about to move some things! So at one point he says, doesn't he say like, chicken it up like Jang-a-Lang?
Oh, probably. That sounds exactly like something Truth would say.
Man, I miss Truth. Yeah, but I kind of, it's... What's Up is really good.
What's Up is great.
Yeah, it's because it's good, but then when he hits the, you feel me, yeah. Say what's up, it's like, oh, okay, all right.
But on the other hand, two real G's and I'm about to get rowdy.
Oh, yeah.
You know you better call somebody.
Ask somebody. And then Road Dogg just killing it.
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, man. That's really good. Did Road Dogg ever sing What's Up With Him?
No, never.
I want to see Road Dogg sing What's Up With Him.
You know what I'm really jealous of?
What's that?
You actually got to come out to What's Up.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Multiple times. And also, we don't talk about... That's a hell of a guitar riff at the beginning of that song. Is Elias playing that guitar?
Maybe he didn't get royalties. That's why they're wrong.
That's the big heat.
No royalties.
Before he started wrestling, Elias was just banking out guitar riffs for people. Got mad at Truth, got jacked, started wrestling so he could fight him.
Roadie Double J, same deal, you know?
Oh, man.
He sang Baby Tonight, dude.
Dang.
Well,
you know, baby. Oh, that's it. That's going to be it.
That's got to do it.
Yeah, shake, rattle, and roll. Elias. With the win.
Elias picking up a dub. Over what's up.
I can't imagine my beard being that big.
I've never been able to hold out, you know. It gets to a point and it just gets real itchy and then it gets annoying because I feel like every bite of food I take, it's just all over my face.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's gone. And then I can't do it.
Do you think yours could grow that big?
Oh, big time. The longest I've ever gone is 2 weeks and it's like
big Truth face.
Yeah. And it's like a full deal.
Yeah, I feel like when we would live together, you would shave. I'd see you shave, and the next day I'd see you with like a full beard.
Yeah.
I'm like, hold on, what is...
Goes quick.
Show us.
Goes quick.
3.5. Okay. Rivalry complete. Dang, that was a 4-star rivalry?
3.
Oh, it can complete on 3 or 4, yeah. You're right.
Last Dunsky.
Okay, we're burning through this. Get around it.
You brought it up.
$8,000.
Here we go.
On top of this ticket money. Okay. The heavyweight champion versus the United States champion.
Look at that popularity, dude. 89,
87.
Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
I like it.
I see it.
I like it. And I see it. Level 4 rivalry. Massive popularity. Level 4 rivalry. Title on the line.
Which one? Which title?
The main title. Our heavyweight title.
Of course.
Two G's.
So you're really just trying to put everything on Reigns, huh?
I'm not.
Never. Well, then why'd you put the heavyweight title on the line then?
Because it's got to be.
Why?
It has to.
For what?
Dude, I mean, that's the granddaddy of them all in the big stadium, you know what I mean? You tell me we're going to book the big stadium and not put the title on the line?
You could put the U.S. title on the line.
I could. But you know the conundrum I'm in. I tried very hard to get the titles away from each other. And
you did. You just can't do it.
Each other, man.
You can't do it.
But this should wrap up the rivalry. Because they're at a level 4 right now. They should be done with this rivalry and we'll part ways. But knowing my luck, Roman will win. And then we'll have a double champion.
And I love that for you.
No.
Check out this power. That's great for you. It's a great move.
Classic G-Bird right there.
Ooh, here we go. I just went to a gaming event with Shelton last weekend. Yeah, Evo. It's a big fighting game tournament in Vegas every year at the Mandalay Bay. I was.
Was Shelton in it?
No, he didn't compete for some reason. He didn't want to. He's like, oh, everybody's too good. But then he saw me play my matches, and he was like, man, I could have played. And I was like, yeah, I know.
He should have done.
I know. He knows now, though. The knee. I won one match.
Was this your first time at Evo?
No, I've been multiple times.
But first time.
I played in the tournaments before, but I've never gotten a win. But I got a win this year, progress.
And was it close, progress. Or did you like smoke?
The first one was close that I lost. The second one I smoked him, and then the next one that I lost was very close. It's aggravating because it's like it's one of those where you're like, man, I should have won that.
Sure.
Yeah. And so in the first match, because I'm dumb and I brought a PS5 controller, I needed a PS4 controller, and so that messed up my whole game. If I had a PS5 controller, then I would have been fine.
What? What's the difference?
You know, there's a curve in the controllers.
Yeah.
So like. You can see.
Yeah.
So there's a curve in PS5 controllers and PS4 controllers. It's flat and it drops off. So I throw with one finger pressing two buttons at the same time. And since it's curved, my finger wraps around it. But on the flat PS4 controllers, I don't hit both of them at the same time. So something else comes out and it just doesn't work. And I don't want to be that guy.
I'm surprised you don't use like that Elite controller.
I just ordered one actually because I was mad about it.
Yep.
I'm done with this.
It's next level stuff, man. I'm surprised.
Yeah. Well, you know, I haven't been competing, you know?
Sure.
I've been playing brands with you, you know?
Yeah.
whooping you here is taking my training time, you know?
Right. Whatever you say, man.
Because, you know, like we said, big arena is nice. It's great. You know, the celebrities there. The celebrities there and stuff, but the people know where the real wrestling's at. They know. They know. In
that small arena.
Yep, smaller arena. In that VFW, baby.
In that tiny arena. You know what was funny, dude? I just went to a concert the other day.
Yeah.
And in the concert, it was a smaller venue, and they had a giant disco ball hanging from the top.
Nice.
Of the reverb room or whatever it's called.
Yeah. Uh-oh.
Like, oh, man. Okay.
Uh-oh. Double champ.
No, kick out Sean.
Double champ.
Sean's got more
games. Double champ. Double champ.
Every time.
Oh, that's great. Look at what you've done.
Can't catch a break on this.
Look at what you've done.
Can't catch a break on this.
Dun 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 dun. Even here. On Battle of the Brands. Art imitates life.
Yeah, that's about it.
Here we go. Four and a half.
Four and a half. I'll take it. No fibers.
Hell of a show.
No fibers on my show.
Hell of a show. Now, my show, in the more intimate setting, you know.
Consistent, no fives.
Consistent, and that's a great show. That's a great show. You probably sold a lot of tickets. You're going to have a lot of money. But WCW, where the big people play. The big people... AKA Andre the Giant opener. Iron Man match.
Of course you do.
Mano e mano for the hardcore championship. Time to spectate. Boom.
Did I write down?
Huh?
Yeah, you got a card on this, don't you?
I do. I think I got multiple cards. I'm gonna have at least 3 5 stars. This is a good size arena. Is that, it does look
bigger
big.
Than mine.
Oh, because it's the pay-per-view arena. So it's a stadium?
Oh.
Booyaka, booyaka! Also, does the cameraman think Ray's coming from up there?
I don't know.
Bro, my arena is way bigger than yours right now.
You're in a stadium.
I am in a stadium. Wow, that pay-per-view arena looks like it might work out for ya, boy! Big Andre coming out.
We'll see.
Look
see
at my
we see
back.
We'll see when we see the numbers.
He said, I'm about to put the show where? On my back. Let's go. My hand is as big as your head.
hand is as big as
yours. I'm gonna pull your gallbladder out through your nipples. Here we go.
Andre Ray.
15 minutes. Goodness. Well, let's sit back and relax for this.
We can always thank you for these ones.
Look at that. I can barely see those people up in the stands. Wow. I'd say we got them hanging from the rafters in here, but we ain't got a roof on the building because the people done blown it off.
We'll check the numbers here.
Yeah, we will. With all these five-star matches inside the stadium. Hell yeah. I'm feeling good. Big Rana. Look at that. Whoa, wow. He's flexible.
Okay.
How do you think Ray versus Andre the Giant would have gone?
I think it would have been a spectacle.
I think so. One for the ages. You think Ray would have slammed him?
No. No, definitely not.
Ooh, death.
But I think it would have been awesome. I think it would have been.
Yeah. How do you think Rey Mysterio would have been received had he been in his prime in like 85?
Ooh, that's interesting.
Cause it's a wide range. It's like smaller playing field, but a more popular playing field. Less channels on TV. Less things going on in the world. No, or the internet's not a thing. So I feel like Rey could have been the. I don't know.
I feel like people would have liked him.
Oh, 100%.
He's just so cool and so good that, like, I don't think it matters the time. I think he still would have been good. You know?
Yeah. But do you think that he would have been doing, like, are we, do we say Rey Mysterio doing the same kind of Rey Mysterio stuff?
I think he would have too.
Yeah.
That's Rey. Damn, I can't picture Rey doing anything else.
That would have blown people's minds.
I think so.
Because it blew our minds later.
Yeah.
If it would have been earlier, psh.
Damn. I think Ray, 80s Ray would have still been good.
He would have been Hogan status, dude.
I mean, Ray versus Hogan, maybe that was a big one. That would have been the big Mania match.
I would have wanted to see, oh, jeez. I would have wanted to see, like, Ray, ooh, okay. Ray versus Macho Man. I don't think he can. I don't think he can.
Is Andre stuck in the crowd?
He might be.
So is he just going to get counted out over and over and over?
Come on. Not like this.
Is Andre just going to get counted out for 12 minutes straight?
We can't do this. Come on. Come on. He's taunting so he can move.
He can't get back yet.
Bro, come on. Andre, you got to come back over the rail. Okay, is Ray going to get him?
Ray can't get him.
Nope. What do we do with this? Oh, no.
Andre can't get in, dude.
Okay. I don't want to quit and simulate.
You got to quit and simulate.
Come on, dude. I really wanted to see this.
Well, then we're watching 11 minutes of Andre in the crowd.
Come on, man.
Ray's going to win like 20-0.
Dude. Okay, go get him, Ray.
He won't. He can't get him.
Dang it.
You better quit and simulate, son.
Use some spectator cameras. Taking it outside the ring now. Hey, guys.
Andre's like, you know what? No.
Come on, Dre.
You know what you gotta do, son.
Dre.
Dre can't get back in, dude.
Dre.
Ray, hardcore champion. That's the match right there, bud.
Quit and simulate. Influence. I don't want to.
You have to.
What if he... Fine.
He's stuck in the crowd, dude.
Whatever, dude. You just robbed us all.
Of what?
We got a great five-star match rivalry. Winner, Andre the Giant. Five-star.
How did Andre five-star win? He was in the crowd.
Because if you read, it said that nothing from this match that you've seen already will influence...
Gotcha.
Ray versus Dre.
And also, how was that a
hardcore? Because
I used a car. I'm pretty sure
the Iron Man match. Five star rivalry grows. 2 to level 3. Yeah, that's great. 5-star match to start us off. Legendary. You see that? Arms crossed. Calling out. Stacy Keebler calling out the Bays. Level 2 to level 3. Mid-card match, one-on-one, normal. Drew McIntyre versus Giovanni. Please. Here? Yeah, I believe so.
Giovanni Vinci.
I think the only reason they don't have a gimmick match is because I ran out of money.
That's probably right.
Pretty
so
sure.
I think I did have some cards that I could use, but...
And you chose not to?
No, because I think I would have had some injuries if I used them. Roman and Shelton were at like 35 stamina. So they were popular, high popularity, level 4 rivalry. They just I didn't want to take the chance of getting injured.
That makes sense. That makes sense. You do like to run your people into the ground.
I do.
Yeah, you do. You just said that you did. You just said that you did.
No, it was question mark at the end.
No, you just told me their stamina was in their 30s.
It was. That's why I took
when it shouldn't have been.
I
wouldn't even take care of them.
You know what? I'm very curious what your stamina is at after this match. After the show.
My stamina? I personally have great stamina.
Your personal stamina. Roster's stamina.
Oh.
And you knew that, by the way. You're just trying to do that. Don't be
that. Stacy called out Shayna 2-2 level 3. Feeling good. Look at those rivalries pumping up for after SummerSlam. Man. You know what's funny too? Because you did have a great show in a big arena. And even though mine is in an even less intimate setting, because I am in the stadium, the people know where the real wrestling's at. They know.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's where the big people play. Yeah. We got this 16x16 ring over here. We like a more intimate mat setting. For those of you who don't know, WWE is a 20x20, which when you go from turnbuckle to turnbuckle, it's 20 feet. In WCW, they had 16x16? Yeah?
Maybe 16, maybe 18.
Yeah, I feel like it was 16.
It might be 16.
I was watching, because I'm this guy, I was watching a bunch of WCW Cruiserweight matches. It was a bunch of Alex Wright matches the other day. And I was like, I know he's big, but this ring is small. This is about to be a countout. And Drew wins by countout. Congratulations.
He runs back out like
no, he's gonna be stunned. Oh, is he gonna make it? Where are you going? Up the stairs?
Wow.
What are you doing?
Wow.
What, he gave up? He just gave up. He was going.
He wasn't gonna slide in. He was gonna go up the stairs.
Yeah, he was going to get Dre.
Going to get Dre stuck in the crowd.
All right, well, come on. Oh, that's good. I'm glad they don't rate these on what the match actually does, because that would have been a half star. Let me see. What do we got?
Like
3 stars?
Into it a little bit.
4 stars! Yes!
I wish it played into it a little bit, you know?
Yeah.
Because then you'd just be like, oh my god, come on.
Oh. Rivalry complete.
Dre gets stuck in the crowd, you get like 1 star.
Rivalry complete. 4 stars. Big singles match. I was having the problem of what to put last.
Ah, yes.
Boom, amazing match. Okay, Booker T calling out Rick Steiner. Rivalry grows level 2 to level 3.
Which also, I feel like you promised Drew a main event match, and then he did not have one.
I think so, too.
I believe there was somebody. I think it was Drew.
It was.
Of course, you were like, yeah, of course. And then did not give it to him.
And then they just get big mad. It's like, I should remember to not do that
if
to
you
them.
If say no, then they'll get mad, but they're
going to get lied to. Well, within the 5 minutes, you're not. It's not really a lie. It's a forget,
sure.
Which is different. That's a different.
Forget is big, yeah.
It's
very
different.
Very different.
Yeah. I had all intentions of giving him the main event, but then when I realized, oh, your match isn't going to be up to main event par, and it's going to, we can either sink the company for your ego or keep it afloat.
True.
So, like, I'd rather that, you know?
I got you.
Save the many, risk the few. Bro, Six is so dope. When I found out that his name in WCW was Six because he was 1-2-3 kid,
yeah.
Man, what a great day.
That Six is pretty cool.
Yeah. Here we go. Look at those gorgeous tag titles. They look really good. Oh, what a team. What a team.
This is a good tag.
Okay. Yeah. King. Yeah. Versus Six and Finn. Man, hell of a sidewalk slam. Kane with the getting out wrestled right now by Six. Uh-oh.
Which also, funny enough, Kane and Six are X-Pac ended up being a hell of a tag team.
Hell of a tag team with Tori by their side. Psh. Until Six got cocky and he shot Kane in the face with a flamethrower. Mm. Which is, oh, what a rude thing to do. So, like, you know when you walk into the arena and people just get jumped? So I feel like when you sign the contract to be a WWE superstar, you agree to assault being legal once you enter the building, embalming included.
But what about attempted, you know, death?
Maybe it's like a statute of limitations thing. Because, like, if we're little kids and I lock you inside of a house and you burn it down, like I'm going to jail. Like, something's happening.
Sure.
But also, where were their parents?
I'm pretty sure that was explained.
That was explained?
I'm pretty sure the parents were inside. I think they died.
So, and then we still cheered for Undertaker after that?
Yes.
Because he probably came to help a babyface at some point? Like, hold on. Back it up.
Wait, Paul Bearer wasn't their dad. I don't think so.
But I vaguely remember them talking about.
They had a whole segment about it.
Yeah. I don't remember how it turned out, though. I gotta look into this. Wrestling was wild, dude.
Pretty crazy.
Okay, where did Kane come from? Oh, this is Undertaker's brother. But where's he been? Oh, we don't know. We just know that Undertaker burned him alive when they were kids. Full stop, dude. We gotta talk about this.
No, it's just how it is.
We gotta talk about this. Does Six's gear say Thug on the front? Notorious Thug.
Does it say Notorious on the back?
Yeah, on the back.
Okay. What does the leg say? Six.
Something. Six Pac. Yeah. I think the front says Thug.
I hope it does. It definitely does.
Yeah. Yeah. It says Thug.
Wait. So is Six? So Six was Six Pac, and was Notorious and Thug. Like, was that like a ode to Tupac and Biggie?
Possibly.
I feel like he's got both, right?
He was just the man, so he's like, I'm gonna do whatever I want.
It's called Six Pac.
Yeah.
He's got Notorious and Thug.
Okay, but this Undertaker Kane thing.
Yeah.
So how, like, then they became a tag team eventually. He's like, hey, dude, I forgive you.
Brothers of Destruction, yeah.
Bro, what?
I forgive you for lighting a house on fire and burning me inside.
No.
That's how it goes.
I hated you so much that I then trained wrestling. So I saw that you were a wrestler. And I got a whole persona and struck a deal with the bosses so that I could jump you at your job where assault is legal and I could get away with all of this.
Yes.
I never once went to the police, or there was never mention of me going to the police. Where's he been this whole time? Just because you don't hide when you're that big. Oh, you're 14 and you're 6'5".
I think it's very clear where he was. He was at the gym. Because he's gigantic, and he was training so that he could beat up Undertaker.
So what, his stepdad was like a weight bench?
Maybe. Spotting him.
So okay, so he trains his entire life to finally beat up Undertaker.
Yeah.
He does, and through their matches, they just settle the beef. And like, okay, we're good now.
Now we're good, yeah.
I got you back.
Yeah.
This, I spent my entire life ostracized. and half burned alive after a few months were Gucci, dude.
Yeah.
I love wrestling.
That's basically it, yeah.
I love wrestling, dude.
Nothing like it. Nothing
it's like the it best. Though. It's the best.
What kind of match did you book here?
A good one.
16 years?
Probably. I think it's the SummerSlam Super Match is what it's technically called.
SummerSlam Super Match.
Yeah, it's a lot of alliteration. Okay. Finn is waiting for Batista to wake up. Or excuse me, Leviathan.
Way different, dude.
Yeah, my bad. The Notorious Thug said, I'll take care of this.
That's right.
Imagine if that move worked that Kane is doing right now and he just smashed his head.
I'm pretty sure I saw that in like a horror movie.
Oh, definitely. It's really them just like squeezing a watermelon, bust open. Somebody's had to have done that. That's no good. Squeezing somebody's head till it pops.
Probably.
Oh, gross.
You ever tried to do that with an apple? When you grab an apple and you try to squeeze it?
No. Have you?
Yeah, it's very difficult.
Did you do it?
No, I can do like a, you can do like a little one, but the bigger it gets, the harder it is to do. I remember testing it and trying to do it, and I couldn't do it.
I don't think I could.
It's like the same as like, you know, like the old like strongman stuff, like ripping the phone book.
Yeah.
You try to defend it.
Not successfully.
I tried,
but
it's tough. Yeah, I can't do it. Couldn't do it.
You know what? So when I was at Evo, we went to this party, and one of the guys who was running security there was friends with Bronson.
Okay.
Bronson is one of our friends who was in FCW with us. Very nice dude. He's like, oh yeah, we're buddies. And he's telling me this story. He's like, yeah, we're at the house, like ripping up license plates. I said, hold on. Ripping license plates? He's like, yeah, he's crazy. How do you rip a license plate?
How do you rip a license plate?
I don't know.
Well, same thing, like bending a frying pan. Like.
Yeah. Have you ever been to one of those shows where they do it?
I've seen it, yeah.
Here we go. The light going out of his eyes. Leviathan. Is he going to go out? Is he going out?
Monster Leviathan.
Uh-oh. Kane's in. For the save. Runs past Finn, who's holding the stairs. Just...
You better not come over here.
Why, I oughta. Yeah. I want to say I saw a show. It was like, I don't remember what they were called, but it was like a group of like religious dudes who were going around and they're doing the tearing the phone books and curling the frying pans with their bare hands and stuff. But it's just like how your grip strength is out of control.
Yeah, it's tough, man. I don't know. I don't even know what people thought of this stuff.
No clue.
You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to rip a phone book.
Yeah.
But you can't.
You got to be a certain level of bored to be like, let me just see.
True.
Let me just find out. The phone book, I don't fully understand, but I half understand. What I really don't understand is, let me see if I can curl this frying pan.
Yeah.
What? Who even thinks that that's something that can be done? And then they did it.
What about like even like with karate and martial arts and stuff? Like breaking boards?
Oh, yeah.
Blocks? People who can like punch through the cinder blocks?
See, that makes more sense to me because if you're punching a cinder block, then when I punch you in the ribs, I'm breaking them.
But like off the top of my head, I'm thinking if I punch this cinder block, my hand's going to break.
Well, I feel like you don't punch the cinder block first. You go from like papaya leaves to
papaya
like
leaves?
Yeah, you start real easy.
What is
Isn't that what they used to write old Sanskrit on?
You're talking about papyrus.
Papyrus?
Because that doesn't like not papaya.
Doesn't that come from papaya leaves? Don't they like dry it out and roll it?
No,
roll it flat. Yeah, then you write on it with you write Sanskrit on it. It's not.
No, way different.
Are you sure?
Papyrus is a different plant altogether.
Is it?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think papaya
has a papaya tree. You could not do anything with those leaves.
Well, if they dried them out and rolled them with rolling pins, maybe.
Absolutely not.
I guarantee you could use a ballpoint pen on those leaves.
Definitely not.
You don't think you could use a ballpoint pen on those? Ballpoint pens write on anything.
I don't think it would be the starting to see if I could punch through a cinder block. I don't think I'd punch through a leaf first.
Well, they probably want to. I would. I'd want to start very easy.
Definitely not a leaf.
It's like when you're about to do a set of bench, you're going to bench the bar, right? Just to warm up a little bit?
Never?
Well, Ooh. Finn Balor in six. Batista tried to save. Eh? He said, excuse me. Yeah, yes, Leviathan. Thug. About this Thug life. This would be a hell of a team, too. Finn in six. Give me five. Five stars, baby.
Woo! This is okay. So I kind of remember how we were booking this. So yeah. you used up all your money on the matches with the cards.
I did.
And I used up my money on the
arena. New rivalry.
That was because I'm pretty sure I had no money left over to do anything.
I didn't either. And Asuka out here advertising. Give me that 13K.
Becky. Dolan.
Yeah. Here we go. Mid-card tables. One-on-one. Spectate. Gigi holding that women's tag championship. Also, too, you vetoed a lot of my, two or three of my angles, didn't you? You got Bailey out of the mix because I was gonna have a tag match. You got somebody else out. So this is my repair show. So I wouldn't have done all this to you had you not done stuff to me first. I had to bring the house down on you.
Sure.
You know? I had to Wicked Witch of the West you.
Bring the house down.
You know? We ain't in Kansas anymore. I would say they're gonna blow the roof off, but it's already gone. Uh-oh, is this the... No, my hair is the real burnt sienna.
Is it burnt sienna?
Yeah.
Is that a thing?
Yeah, it's a color. Burnt sienna? Sienna? Yeah, burnt sienna.
I feel like that's wrong.
No, it's not. Because neither of them are orange.
Like burnt something, but not sienna.
It's burnt sienna.
I don't think so.
Let's see. Well, let's check Google.
Doesn't sound right to me.
Burnt... Burnt sienna is the exact color that I'm looking at right now. Burnt sienna is orange mixed with brown. Yeah, boom. Got you. Oh, well, Google doesn't lie. The internet never lies, dude.
It never could. How would it?
I'm doing something. A big thing. Switching from iPhone to Samsung.
Oh! Why?
Because I'm just doing a bunch of stuff, dude.
What made this occur?
It's huge. And so I got the new flip phone, but I meant to get the fold. The flip is the smaller one that flips, and the fold is the one that opens up like a book. And I wanted to switch to that one because every time I saw somebody with it, they were super happy. I would always ask them about it, and they just like loved it.
Wait, is that the touch screen?
Yeah.
But it like closes. Yeah, it looks cool. It looks very cool.
Yeah, and the camera's really nice on it. But somebody told me one of the Google phones is better to them. So they said on this Google phone, you could have a screen open doing like a video call. And on the other side of the screen, if the person is speaking like Spanish or something, the left side of the screen will translate what they're saying in real time.
That's kind of cool.
So it's like, that's dope. So, but I imagine this fold phone will do that. It has to, right?
Well, and realistically, when are you ever going to use that? Great feature, but you'll never use that.
I mean, you don't know. Maybe I'll go out and purposely
Not
make
once
friends.
Will you ever use that?
That's only because I speak Spanish.
Sure, that's why.
Maybe when I go live in Japan for a little bit.
Is that what's going to happen?
Yeah. When I go cut promos in Japan, I'll just bring my phone with me and do them like that.
Sure. Wow. So you've already made the switch.
No, so what I'm doing is trying it out. So I got like a new phone line. I'm gonna try it out for like a month or two. And then if I like it, then I'll switch my number to this phone. But I'm just, I wanna see, what I'm really worried about is losing my blue text.
That's what I was gonna say. You give me those green text messages.
Yeah, but I don't, so this is the issue. So I was always nervous to get my nose pierced. I said, screw it, let me go get my nose pierced. I did it.
You got dubs, dubbed it up.
Doubled up, but that's only because I want the ring in one and the stud in the other. And I didn't know you had to wait like 5 or 6 months to get the ring because it's got to heal. So I was like, well, let me just get the other one. And I've always wanted to see what it's like to be on the other side, you know, Android style, Samsung style, Google style. And what's out? iPhone 14 is the latest iPhone, I think. And I've been on iPhone 11 because, like, I don't know, they don't, to me, the upgrades aren't enough to switch phones.
Oh, I never switch immediately. I'm not paying that much.
Yeah.
And again, obviously, you know, there is other options because people do them all the time and they wouldn't mm-hmm. be around if nobody did them. But that's just a big style change, man.
Huge. Especially because I've been iPhone since iPhone came out.
So, which, funny enough, so a lot of people on computers, so like I'm iPhone phone, mm-hmm. but I'm PC computer. I can't use a MacBook or like any of that stuff.
Yeah.
I don't like the operating system. I can't figure it out.
Yeah. I'm the same way. You see everything else. But I do have an iPad.
iPad. Okay. See, I had an iPad and I didn't like it.
That's fair. Do you have any sort of tablet?
I have a tablet. I have a Surface Pro.
Okay. I have a Surface Pro too. I love that thing. That's what I was using to play games for the longest time. I'd put emulators on it and travel with that.
Yeah, I was traveling with it, and I could actually stream off of it. It was powerful, man.
You were streaming off of it?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Dude, it's powerful, man.
You didn't know all that. Oh, no, okay. But yeah, so I got I accidentally ordered the Fold, and so I have to wait till tomorrow to go and switch it out, because they were like, well, you can't switch it out because it's not out yet. I'm like, yeah, but I pre-ordered it. They're like, yeah, but you pre-ordered the wrong one. I was like, yeah, so can I just switch it?
What do you mean you pre-ordered the wrong one?
So there's a Fold, which opens up like those old Razer phones.
Yeah.
And the Flip is the one that's longer and opens like a book.
You wanted that one.
Yeah. And so when I was in the place, there's just, the names are very close.
Sure.
And so it's a me problem. Okay. So I try to switch it out, but I got to wait till tomorrow. So when you get a text from a random number and it's green text, it's me. Come on, dude. I got
to
see if I like this phone. That's the only thing I'm worried about is the text. Everything else, I'm like, I'm ready.
The text will be fine.
I don't know. I'm going to lose a bunch of group text.
Oh, that's true. Well, you won't lose them. You'll just be in them. You'll just be the weird green guy.
I feel like I'm in multiple group texts with you.
Several, yeah.
And I'm going to get crap from you in all of them.
Oh, we'll be like, who's this green guy?
Yeah, as if you didn't just give me crap in a different group text.
That's right. But I'll give you back all the group texts. That's the beauty of group texts.
So we'll see.
That's a big decision, man.
It is.
And again, I'm sure that the phones are good. But to make the switch, that's big.
Yeah, man. So we'll see. We'll give it like 2 or 3 months, and then if I like it, then that'll be
What's the biggest thing for you on if you like it or don't like it?
I don't know. Ooh.
Whoa.
That was almost. I'm not sure because I feel. I don't know.
I feel like the tech would be big enough to deter you.
I don't know what I'm looking for. I think I just want something new or something different. I know what I get out of iPhone. I know I'm in the ecosystem. I know I continuously put money into it because I got all these apps and all this stuff. And it's like, well, am I in this because I'm used to it? I'm just comfortable with the platform and all that stuff. Or do I want to mess with something new?
But now also, you're not gonna have an Apple ID, which has all of your contacts and all your other stuff. So you gotta start from scratch.
No, you can port stuff over pretty easy.
Can you?
Yeah, but and also too, I can't tell you how full my phone is of contacts that I never contact.
Well, sure. but like I, that's. Everything I have is, I think, wrapped up in Apple ID, right? So if you switch, you're going to lose something or, like, have to start at scratch again, right? How do they switch it over?
I'm pretty sure you can port a lot of stuff. I saw something, it's like, oh, you think you'll lose all your pictures? And it's like, no, it ports over pretty easy, but I'm not trying to port pictures over because I'm trying to dump those on the computer.
Yeah.
The contacts, I can go through, and I guarantee you through each letter, I can dump, like, 50 people. Because I have multiple numbers for a lot of people, and then I have a bunch of random numbers of people that like either just don't talk to anymore or anything like that, you know? Because in reality, like how many contacts do you need in your phone?
Yeah.
You know?
I get that.
You gotta water the grass where you need to.
Sure. Water the grass. I don't know. And also, maybe you're expecting a little too much out of your phone.
What do you mean?
If you're just looking for something new, you know what I mean?
Also, you can put a bunch of emulators that I have on my computer onto that phone.
But don't you have emulators on, like, everything else? It's all the same.
I do, but...
How many things do you need to play games on?
On everything. That's what's important to me, you know?
Well, you got a Steam Deck, which you're gonna play.
I do. I have a Steam Deck. I have my Switch, which you can't put emulators on, but you got the Switch games.
Yeah.
You can put everything on Steam Deck, honestly, sure. And plug the glasses in.
So why do you need the phone?
I don't need it at all. I'm not saying that I need it at all, but I want it.
That's okay.
I would like to try it to check my options.
Sure.
It's like you go to a buffet and you see something that you want and you eat it, but then you're like, man, I should have tried this too. And then you leave and it's too late. Because I can try it, no harm, no foul.
Sure.
Or I can try it and love it and just go ahead and switch.
I get it.
Give yourself options.
Options are good.
It's the same mentality as the people who tell me that I should eat more vegetables. Mm. You should just try them. Just try them. Okay, I'm trying it.
I can't tell you the last time I had a vegetable.
Really? Oh, yeah, you're full meat. How long has it been?
At least 6 months.
That you have not eaten any vegetables? Can you tell your diet to the people that don't know?
oh my god.
Becky with the
animal
win.
Based, dude. Animal based. So, majority meat, protein high, and then fruit, a lot of honey. Started drinking beer.
What is that?
It's like unpasteurized. It's unpasteurized fermented milk. So, basically, like, you know how people are lactose intolerant?
Yeah.
So it basically messes with the lactose so that it's easier to digest. But it's also very, very good, and there's been a lot of benefits proven from it.
Like they put in a lab and mess with it?
No. You put they're called kefir grains, and it basically ferments the milk.
Okay.
So it's almost like it doesn't taste bad. I don't drink it by itself. I mix it with orange juice and it tastes like a creamsicle.
What?
Yeah, it's great.
That sounds awesome.
It's very good. But it's almost just like, you know how like Greek yogurt is kind of like that sour taste?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the same as that. But a lot of benefits. Look up kefir. A lot of benefits.
Oh. Okay. All right, we got heavyweight champion Bad Bunny.
Bad Bun.
You're defending against big sexy Kevin Nash.
There you go.
In a steel cage.
Ooh, interesting.
Spectate. Kevin Nash is on the brink of being unhappy. So let's see if he can.
He's tough to have on a show, man.
Bro.
I've had him several times, and he always gets mad at me, and I let him go.
Is it every version of Nash,
yeah.
Or just this one?
Yeah, no, everyone.
Dang.
Everyone is tough to keep on show, man. He just does not stay happy.
Come on, Nash, I believe in you. This is NWO Nash 2. Bad Bunny.
You have caught heavy on the show.
Hell yeah. WCW Championship. Look at this bad boy. Look at this title. Show it to me. Show it to me. Show me the match. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. This is not a good start for Bad Bunny.
Oh, my God.
Kevin Nash wins.
You imagine?
Bro, what if he just gets out? Weren't we saying this is our version of Ready to Rumble? It'd be Bad Bunny instead of David Arquette.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That triple cage.
Powerbomb. Man, I love the triple cage.
I don't know why they never tried it again.
I don't know. There was like 10 people in that match.
In the Ready to Rumble version?
No, in the one that was on TV.
Yeah. I feel like they... I don't know. It's definitely an option.
Let me see.
You know what I mean? I feel like people would like it. At this point, it's classic. Vintage.
Mega Powers versus the Alliance.
There's also, I don't know if you've ever watched that. There was also not a good match.
What?
Triple K.
Oh, no.
The Ready to Rumble version is great.
Well, because, okay, here. This one. I feel like there's another one. There's one which is like everybody is in it. I'll find it. Here we go. Oh, dope. This was...
They've only done one, right?
Yeah, and it was actually on my birthday in the year 2000.
Really?
Yeah, September 4th. I'm looking at the Deadlock Boys watching it. Also, I don't know if they'll actually show clips. I think it's just them talking about it. Ah, dang. Good dudes, though. We'll find it and talk about it later. Okay, Bad Bunny, Kevin Nash.
Why is Nash mad at you?
I think he's just been losing.
He's getting a title shot.
Yeah.
He's getting mad, dude.
Yeah. Well, he's not mad. He's got the perturbed emoji. The side eyes.
If he loses this one, you're gonna be in.
100% going to Raw if he loses this. Also, Bad Bunny jumping to Kevin Nash's shoulders from the ground. Here we go. Choke slam. This might be it for the bun. Pain. Oh, he said, fine, screw it. Let me power bomb.
Right into a jackknife.
Bye. Pinning him.
Oh, you can pin him in a cage.
Wow. And that's... Okay.
Nash with what? Also, what a great finish that would be. Big yeah. Choke slam, nip up, jackknife, done.
Immediately into the power bomb.
That's great.
Okay, Nash will be happy. Look at him. He's like, you damn right. Yeah. We're not gonna let these entertainers come in here and take our titles.
Finally.
Oh. Okay, give me that 5-star. 5-star rivalry complete.
Give me those cards, bud.
Bad Bunny.
That's a big
5-star complete. Here we go.
Very curious for the numbers on this one.
I got big old numbers.
See if the big stadium was worth it.
Of course it wasn't.
You weren't gonna say that.
I wasn't.
I can hear you half give up on your sentence as you were saying it. Of course it wasn't.
I had to bail.
Yeah.
All right. Ooh. What a show. Amazing booking from Raw.
Amazing booking.
Amazing. But what's above amazing? Sky, nothing. Yep. Nothing's above amazing. Okay, so you need to check anything?
I think just that. Go down.
Oh, sorry.
Level 2. Yep, go down. Level 4. Grayson, then move that, move that. Okay. Lies and Truth, done. Oh, Michelle, done.
And call out, Piper, yep. Waller, 1.
Yep, we're good.
Kangaroo,
we're
good. 2. Okay, let's see. Okay, 3. Complete, yep. To level 1. Complete. Booker Steiner, 3. Stacey Shayna, 3. Man, just really, really doing the thing. You got rid of Adrian Buck? Wow.
Old Buck boxers over there. Yeah. 240,000.
Yeah.
Okay.
Damn, Raw, you just gonna sign Waller and let his career rot?
Lax.
Dang.
146,000, made 241. Okay, so I was really at like $0, I'm pretty sure.
No, you had 30K?
Yeah, I was down there.
Jeez. All right. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. 308 with the budget. Okay.
Oh, we're week 20. I thought it was 16. My God.
Oh, no. Six and Baylor. Balor, incredible tag team. Fan change looking good.
190.
Okay.
And you lost 23,000.
Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Not we're a bad okay. SummerSlam.
Oop, sorry.
Alright, press it. Alright. Ooh, it's close, bud.
Wow.
It's close.
Wow.
It's close.
Oh, man. But you have the big arena.
Yep. 40,000 difference in fans.
Mm-hmm.
100,000 in money. But I got the big arena unlocked.
Mm-hmm.
Whether or not that makes a difference, we'll see.
It will. It will starting now. Because I was in the pay-per-view arena, so I have to get the big arena to do anything. Yeah. Yeah.
Alright, let's take a look at these emails, bud.
Alright.
I don't know if it's you or me.
Buffalo, 4 weeks till Mania.
Oh my god, we're almost halfway through, bud.
Jeez.
Oh god. Okay. Shotzi, contract is up.
Oh, I gotta press the button. Yeah. Oops. Contract is up at the end of the week. What you want?
How about 20?
Okay.
Yeah, we're good.
Okay. Contract is up.
How about 14?
Okay. I don't think so.
Thanks for your work. I will not be renewing.
Wow.
Flatback zone. See you, Zai.
Flatback zone.
High emotion intensity between superstars resulted in two level moves. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I saw that.
Mm-hmm.
Special mischief attack, which they have capacity to jump two levels, even without special rules. It won't happen every time, but there's always a chance. Okay. Oh, that's why tag matches are
key. Yeah.
It's because they can do that and singles can't. Okay.
Yes.
I like that.
He told us that, or he told me that maybe.
Yeah, I'm sure he's
shielding it from you.
Helping you.
No, I just had it happen before you because I focus on my tag division. Sure, unlike right. Some people. Jeez.
How about giving me the courtesy of a heads up next time? Oh, that's because I interfered.
Yeah.
Okay. Whatever.
I said whatever.
I haven't had any matches in a while. Put it back where I want. I want a match in the next show. Yeah, we can make that work, son.
Sure thing?
Sure thing.
How about cutting a promo instead? Sure thing.
Been way too long, my friend.
Yeah. Okay. Nice. Exit and continue to booking.
Don't look. Don't you dare look.
I didn't look.
I'll tell you.
But I have to look to.
No, I'll tell you what to do.
Okay.
Press right and press X.
My turn?
Nope.
What's up now?
It's my turn to book.
Oh, okay. Okay, so the game is very close right now.
40,000.
Got to get this big arena if I want to stay in any sort of competition. But as you guys know, you've been watching along, WrestleMania is the halfway point for us. And then we're doing another season, and that'll give us the 52 weeks, or actually the 50 weeks.
52 weeks.
Jeez, it is going. This is rough. This is intense.
Man, this got real. Show 21, that was a big SummerSlam.
Yeah, that was huge.
That was a huge SummerSlam, and we're almost halfway. The halfway point's like daunting.
Hell of a show from WCW.
WCW, they cashed in with those cards.
Yeah, you know, that's what we got to do. That's what we got to do. Probably should have saved them for Mania, but that's fine. But it's going to be okay.
Oh, yeah.
So catch us next week. Same YouTube channel, same time. What else is the same? Yeah, all right. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. But most importantly, make sure you always and forever keep it.